I'm going to talk a little bit about TPM and Windows 11 in 2023. We are just getting into this year, and I've been using Windows 11 since it came out, so over a year. My computer supports TPM. I also have run Windows 11 for free without activating it by downloading an ISO on VirtualBox and VMware that now supports TPM emulation. So VirtualBox, you need version 7 and yep, to get TPM enabled. And it's been quite stable. I've been doing live streams with it. It do blue screens once in a while. I think the TPM emulation is a little bit iffy-diffy. But the VMware we ran our live stream where I used the Windows 11 Pro in there for like 4 hours almost without having any problem updating and doing all kind of crazy shit. I have noticed nothing to TPM. And I've talked to a lot of people and they say the same. Is TPM an irritation for a lot of people that are about to buy, or not buy, but want to upgrade to Windows 11 but need new hardware? It can be, but you have to remember one thing. 99%, and this is not a fact, it's just me saying that most people only upgrade Windows when they buy new hardware anyway. That's just the fact of it. Most people upgrade Windows when they buy new hardware. So if they're going out to buy a new laptop or desktop or whatever they are buying, it's already TPM compatible. It already runs Windows 11. So for them, it's a non-issue. And the people that may upgrade to Windows 11, they do it because they get a little notification saying, "Hello, me little Microsoft fanboy down here. I want you to upgrade to Windows 11. Please press my butthole." And then they press the butthole, and now they upgraded to Windows 11. The whole notion that everyone is running out of their fucking way to install Windows 11 is false. And that's kind of, again, this is something that the Linux community, they tend to forget. Because under Linux, when we get a new version of Ubuntu, Mint, whatever the fuck it is, we upgrade right away. That's kind of what we do under Linux. We upgrade right away. Or we're running a rolling release like Arch, Tumbleweed, stuff like that, and we just upgrade all the fucking time. The Windows world is vastly different. It takes about 3 years plus before the majority of Windows users have migrated over to the current version of Windows. Actually, if you look at the adoption rate for Windows 11 within the first year, it's in the top 3 of all Windows releases. So that means that how many people have upgraded to the newest release, to the newest version of Windows within the first year? Windows 11 is in the top 3. Either top 4 or top 3, I can't remember right now. But I mean, what the fuck, DistroTube made a video I reacted to that Linux is as popular as heart disease, where I went in there and found, you know, data points. So it's actually being adopted way faster than most of other Windows releases have been upgraded. So TPM must not be an issue for a lot of people. And again, like I said before, most people only upgrade versions of Windows anyway when they buy new hardware. That's why it takes these like 3 to 4 plus years before most people are using the new version of Windows, because they are using the current version they have of Windows right now until their hardware needs to be replaced. My mom is still running Windows 8. I know a lot of people still running Windows 10 because their hardware runs, they can do everything they want, they don't need new hardware, so they just keep running Windows 10. If I ask them, should I upgrade? Why would you do that? This is fine, this is working for me. They don't give a fuck. They're like, "Oh, I just buy a new computer and this one can't do what I wanted to do anymore." That's how the vast majority of people are living their life. So Windows 11 and TPM in 2023 is not going to be an issue. People that can't upgrade, they just keep using Windows 10 and don't give a fuck about anything else. People that want to run Windows 11, they either buy new hardware or they wait till they need to buy new hardware. That's how people actually live their life when it comes to computing. So all of this flack that you get with Windows and TPM, I get it. It's irritating that if you really, really want the latest and greatest for Windows and you don't have or your computer is more than 5 years old, you need to upgrade it. I get that. It's just that if you look at Windows 11 from a hobbyist viewpoint, like a computer hobbyist viewpoint, it's a massive blow to the balls. But the vast majority of the world is not computer hobbyists. They really are not. And that's why you see that when a new version of Windows comes out, everyone don't just automatically update it like we do under Linux. So with Linux, yeah. So looking at Windows 11 and the CPM debacle and how the Windows community is using Windows, it's not that big of a deal. Have I heard people bitching and moaning about it? Of course I have. I've heard a lot of Windows users bitch and moan about it. You know who those Windows users were or are? They are Windows or computer hobbyists. They use their computer in a way that the vast majority of people are not. So they are dual booting a shit ton of operating systems. They are doing operating system development. They are always buying the newest graphic card, the new CPU every year. They are on the bleeding edge of new technology. Those are the people I've heard bitching and moaning, not your average consumer. My personal opinion on the CPM stuff, as it always has been, is that it should have been an option for the Home Edition. The Home Edition should not have CPM. When you go Pro and up, you know, the professional version of Windows 11, put CPM in there, because that's mostly intended for corporations, you know, professionals and stuff like that. Yeah, put CPM in there. And we have to remember the way we think about computers, the way we use computers, is not a measuring stone about how everyone else is doing it or should be doing it. We are really specific people using hardware and software a lot of times in a really specific way. Anyway, I'm out of here. See you all later. Have an amazing day. Bye-bye.